Hello, as usual, I'm a honorable, and as I've been asked to share my experience over these past 6 weeks during my meditation in internal medicine. Funny enough, 6 weeks just passed by without me even realizing how fast the days were moving. And now we are done with internal medicine. Practically, we've been got 3 floors to internal medicine, and we were on each floor for 2 weeks. And the number of interventions that we made, that was more impactful. People started appreciating us, and it was the best of feeling that you could have, that your knowledge is helping save someone's life. At a point you go around and you'll be standing by a patient, you realize that there is something that should be done that isn't being done for this particular patient. You make an input and it is accepted. You come back and the patient is feeling far better than you met them. And you feel better yourself because you know that at least you didn't waste 6 years in school for nothing. And also, we had some challenging cases as well on the ward. Cases where we just didn't know how to go about it. Like people consulting all over, but most of the times we do our best. And even as students, we also do our best to read more so that we will come and communicate with our preceptors and all the other people in charge, so that various decisions that are made will help our patients. And with what I realized on the ward, I realized that I don't know if it happens to be this part of Ghana that is really happen to be working in Tamale Teaching Hospital. I don't know if it happens to be with the northern part of Ghana, but a whole lot of patients come, especially when we're on the 3rd floor. Where we had the GIT cases, a whole lot of people come with liver problems, and the cause of majority of these people's liver problems were the use of herbal preparations. And also we realized that a number of people were also suffering from hepatitis B and C infection. I think we want to send a word out there about the use of herbal medicines. Like, we should be particular about its use. Before you get to use any of these medications, make sure it is authorized to be used for the condition that you are using. Don't just pick anything because somebody says it's good. And also with the hepatitis B and hepatitis C, the way it is carrying people around, I think we should start doing more of an advocacy job for it. And everyone should also try and get tested or screened for hepatitis B and C as well. Also, there were times that it was sad to see somebody pass away because you've been managing the patient for a while and you're doing everything possible, you're doing everything according to the doctor, you expect the patient to be improving, but only God knows why such patients do not improve. So at the end of the day, when you lose a patient that you put so much effort into helping, it's a sad thing to happen to you. And on one or two occasions, we actually experienced things like that. But on the brighter side, we had a very good time together with my colleagues. Even though when we came, being our first rotation, it was very difficult to integrate into the system. But the kind of preceptors we have, where they are acquainted with the system and their inputs are also felt because they are knowledgeable in what they are doing. Now what am I supposed to talk about again? The acceptance of funding.
I think you can edit.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so yeah, it's still on.
It's still on. So okay, let me go back. Basically,
Man.
The the practice of Fandi here in Tamale Teaching Hospital is well integrated. Say that even though I'm still a student, I can walk into any of the wards that I've been assigned to, pick a patient's folder and go through it and make an input where necessary. So that I remember just yesterday, I walked into the ward later in the day. I went through it and I realized that there was a particular medication the patient was supposed to receive but wasn't getting. So I had to do the necessary follow-ups and the patient was then given that medication. When I was leaving to the house, I felt good. At least this is why I chose to read doctor of pharmacy, and I think it is now paying off. And even though there were some challenges, but most of the times we are able to integrate well with the other clinical team. One thing I've also realized about pharmacy is that to be a very good pharmacist, you have to be an all-round person. You can't just study medicines and say you are a pharmacist, because now you need to know the understand the diagnosis that the doctors are making, why they even came to arrive at that diagnosis. You need to understand what the nurses are doing. You need to understand what the lab technicians also come with us in the lab results. You should be able to interpret the lab results. You should be able to ascertain how well the interventions that the nurses are putting in place are, and even the diagnosis and medications that the doctors are selecting are. And as such, to be effective, you also need to have a good rapport with all these people. So on the ward, we needed to be able to acquaint ourselves with the patients, their treatment, and even we needed to be able to communicate well with the doctors as well as the nurses on the ward. And so far, so good. For the past 6 weeks, we have nice times, challenging times, all the experiences you can imagine. Finally, the 6 weeks is over. I can't say that I've learned everything. There is a whole lot to learn. And now I even realize that I still have more to learn. So I'm going to sit up. But the nice thing about it is that because of the experiences I've had in the world, like we going for board rounds, being introduced to cases and the challenges we meet, it makes the learning more practical now. It's not like back in school when I needed to memorize things for exams. Now I know that the input I'm going to make is to save a life, and therefore it's important for me to get to some point. I need to make every input that I make should be correct, and I can say that I've enjoyed the 6 weeks. So next week we are moving to our next rotation, which happens to be ops and gyn, and I want to keep you posted on it. Bye.